Okay, it's been a long time since I've done two videos in one day, although you probably won't see this one until tomorrow. And the reason I'm coming on today is because I wanted to let you know that I am going to be documenting 90 days of raw food for me. Yay! I've been wanting to do that for a long time. I can tell you that the better part of the last quarter or more of last year, 2017, probably part of August, all the way up through maybe December 17th, I was probably 100% raw, most of it, most of that time. And I felt the best that I've ever felt in my life. And quite frankly, I eat a pretty high raw diet, but there is something about eating all raw foods. And it's not just about raw foods, it's about, you know, the living foods. And it just makes me feel really good. Other foods, unfortunately, make me feel a little sluggish. I mean, not terribly sluggish, but more sluggish than actually eating a living foods diet. So I am going to embark on going living foods, raw foods, 100% for the next 90 days, starting tomorrow. I don't know what tomorrow's date is. I want to say it's the 27th of February. And I'm going to take you along with me. I'm not sure how I'm going to do this. I'm not that great at vlogging because I'll vlog a little bit and then I'll forget to do it. And then I'll be missing like a day and a half and then I'll have to catch up and all that good stuff. So I think what I'm going to do is just come on video when I can, and I'll post as often as I can, and I'll take you along with me. And also, I'm in the process of writing my cookbook. So a lot of the recipes that I will make during this time will be from this experience. And already in the cookbook, I've probably got about, I want to say, 20 recipes that I've already added to the cookbook. I'm so excited about that. Most of the questions that I get on a daily basis is, well, if I can't eat this, well, what can I eat? And when I say eat fruits, vegetables, nuts, and seeds, and I get like this look, like deer in the headlights kind of look, and I have to remember that everyone I'm talking to hasn't come from the same background as I have. I've been working on this stuff for years, so I can go in the kitchen and create anything I want easily, and it will be compliant and it will taste good. And everybody cannot do that. And so I have to remember that. And also I have to remember that I had to learn too. And everybody's skill in the kitchen is not the same. Now I have to remember that. So that's part of the reason why I'm coming out with the book, because I want to create recipes not only that are fibroid eliminators or fibroid friendly recipes, but I want them to be quick, simple, and inexpensive. Something that, you know, a busy person can put together in no time and it not be an issue. And the other reason why I want to do this 90-day challenge is because my body does not release weight when I eat cooked food. It just doesn't. Like, it just doesn't. I don't know if it has to do with my age or what, but whenever I eat raw food, the weight, you know, comes off steadily. I mean, it's not like flying off the shelf, but it's, you know, it comes off steadily. And when I eat cooked foods, even when I eat cooked foods that are not like heavy. It can be, you know, a big salad with, you know, beans on it, or, you know, steamed vegetables on top. It's like it slows my body down. And so that is another reason why I'm doing it. I really need to get the rest of this weight off of my body. And that's something that I want to do. I have maybe about a good 40 pounds that I need to lose to be at a decent weight for myself. And, and right now I'm not terribly overweight like I used to be. I used to be, I honestly don't know what how much I weigh right now, but I used to, my heaviest recorded weight was 217 pounds, and I'm nowhere near that, nowhere near that anymore. So, even though I am eating some cooked foods, I do feel my body still going through detox and all that stuff, like all that's happening, but I'm telling you, it's not, I'm not releasing weight. So that's one of the other reasons why I want to do this. So we'll see. And I'll take you along with me and share the journey with you. And hopefully you will glean some tips and tricks along the way. When I opened up my the group in Facebook, the Foods to Avoid to Shrink Fibroids Naturally Facebook group. It opened up my eyes to really how many women around the world are suffering with this epidemic, the female issue epidemic. And it's mostly fibroids that I'm running into because that's what, you know, people are attracted to, in, you know, because of my story with fibroids. But there are women who have all kinds of problems in this area, and we don't have to suffer. I am no longer suffering with these symptoms. Like I'm just not. And you don't have to either. You don't have to get a hysterectomy. You don't have to get surgery. You can have children. Like, you don't have to, you know, go through all of this. But it's not just about food. Let me just say that right now. It's not just about food. Food is a big part of it, but it's not just about food. You have to get to the root cause, the root emotional cause, because you can eat all the right foods that you want to eat all day long, but if you don't get to the root, the emotional root of this, you will, those fibroids will not budge. You might feel a little bit better, but they're not going anywhere unless you deal with your issues. And what I'm finding through the more and more people that I coach, I'm finding that there are some people who are willing to do whatever it takes to go and get those issues. And there are some women who are not willing. They just don't even want to have anything to do with looking at their emotional state. And there's also some women who have a hard time tapping into that emotional place, and the emotions that they are feeling, they think are normal. Like if they feel sad, or if they feel angry or bitter or whatever their emotion is that they're feeling, and it's a negative emotion, they think that that's normal and that, you know, there's no problem. But I'm telling you, our life was not meant to be lived in a negative place like that, in emotional turmoil. That's not how God created us to be. I'm not saying that we would lay on a bed of roses and everything would be peachy king for the rest of our lives and we'd never have problems. I'm not saying that. But we're not supposed to live in emotional turmoil, is what I'm saying. And depressed all the time and negative all the time. We're not supposed to live like that. So if you are living like that, stop, reach out for some help and find out how you can tap into what's going on in your heart. That is one of the things that I work on with women when we do one-on-one coaching. And we tap into it. I teach you how to tap into it in the group program that I have as well. And even the fibroid detox, the online e-course, I talk about having to tap into it, and I give you a few tips on how to do that. But really, if you need to go deep, if you've got some deep wounds in your heart, it'd probably be beneficial if you actually did get some one-on-one coaching. But if you want to get rid of fibroids and all those female health issues, you've got to be able to deal with that stuff. And it's unfortunate that a lot of people think that there's nothing wrong with them. They say, oh, I'm fine. I don't have any issues. And in their brain, they're cussing people out. They're thinking about the next time they talk to the person, what they're going to say to them, and how they'll never forgive this person because they did this, that, and the other to them, and wonder why they have the female issue that they're struggling with. So that's just a little bit of information there. I don't even know why I went off on that. Whoops. I don't even know why I went off on that tangent, because truth be told, I wasn't supposed to talk about that in this video. I'm talking about 90 Days of Raw. That is going to be starting tomorrow. So anyway, y'all, I will talk to you all later. See ya. Love you. Bye.